Imagine there's a major disaster. Utilities stop working. Law and order breaks down. You can't call 911. You're pretty much on your own. You got to come up with your own food and water. How long do you think you will be able to survive after SHTF? Hey guys, welcome back to the Dimcat channel. I'm Reginald, also known as Dimcat. How long would you be able to last? Well, I'm going to talk about how long I think I could last based on my resources, but it's more than just resources. It's your skills, it's your knowledge. Knowledge can really put you in a really good position to do well or at least survive in that type of situation. And that's something I always need to definitely work on, knowledge. But as far as resources, as far as food and water, I want to talk about the importance of assessing your own capabilities and what you really have. It's important because it helps you plan. Like if you only have a 3-day supply of food and you know you're on day 15, then you know that you got about 15 days to come up with additional food, additional resources, additional water, or whatever you need. You don't just want to have some 30 days worth of food and not realize you only have 30 days worth of food and just figure you're going to keep eating at whatever rate you're eating at or drinking at whatever rate you're drinking at, and you'll just figure it out later on. You want to be able to plan ahead. That's part of prepping. So let's sort of assess my food, starting with the food situation. The food situation is sort of linked to the water simply because I rely on freeze-dried foods, such as this Valley Food Storage and this Mountain House and this Ready Wise. You need a certain amount of water, I think a cup of water to put in here, and you have 2 cups of boiling water. So that means I also have to have a plan to actually heat up water in case the grid goes down. So that's something I got to think about as well, how I can boil water for this need. So if I know I need 2 cups a day and I'm going to be consuming 1 pack a day or 2 packs a day, if I'm consuming 2 packs, 2 pouches a day, then I'm going to need 4 cups of water. Something to keep in mind. Okay, so I have canned goods, everything from stuff like this, soups, can full of chicken. So I counted everything that I had and I decided that, first, Mountain House. Freeze-dried food. This right here, I have about 39 pouches. 39 pouches of these right here. All right, 39 pouches. Ready Wise, I have 21 pouches. 21 pouches. This also requires 2 cups of boiling water. Right. Valley Food Storage, 12 pouches. That's a total of 62 pouches. I think I got about 62 pouches. And, 5 freeze-dried cans. They're pretty big size freeze-dried cans. Now, my expected consumption will be 2 pouches per day. 2 pouches per day, or maybe a half can, half a 10-ounce, number 10 can. It's called a number 10 can, not a 10-ounce can, number 10 can. Half of them per day. So, with the pouches, it should last me 31 days if I have 2 pouches per day. Now, obviously, I should be able to get by with just 1 pouch because it's already right here. This should be plenty of calories right here. I might not even have to add 2 because when you look at the amount of calories on here, I should be able to get by with just 1. But worst case scenario, maybe I have to share with somebody else. That's something you might want to plan, especially if you have a family or if you have a girlfriend or if you have a boyfriend or whatever. I mean, we're going to say, no, you can't come over and eat when it hits the fan. You might say that. I don't know. I mean, so we're looking 31 days with the pouches, 10 days with the number 10 cans. That's a total of 41 days. That's supposed to be for 1 person, but, you know, 2 of these pouches, well, I'll say 2 of these pouches. These pouches tend to be a little bit bigger. Seem like they have more, but I don't know. I think it's reasonable, 2 of these per day. For 1 person, and maybe one day you go with just 1, and other days you might go with 2. So that's a total of about 41 days. It's also important to look at the water too. We're gonna talk about that in a second because you need the water for that as well. But for the canned goods, this is different. You don't really need a lot of water for that. You may have to heat it up though. That's something you got to consider for the canned goods. Alright, so I have 177 regular canned goods. Now basically all this stuff goes into one category as regular. The chili, the soup, the chicken, this is all considered to be regular. I have 177 cans. The fruits, it'll go along with it, but that's separate. 39 cans of fruit soup, well, 49 fruit cans, okay, and 177 regular cans, right? So I expect to be using maybe two cans per day. And if we go by two cans per day, you know, that'll probably give me about 59 days of the regular canned goods. Also, with the fruit, maybe with the fruit in there, additional 15 days. So that's a total of 74 days. 74 days. So 74 days with this canned goods stuff. All right. And then the freeze-dried food, maybe 41 days. So I'm thinking a total of maybe 115 days in all. Now, this doesn't include items such as peanut butter. It does not include the noodle soups I had, those dry noodle soups. We just add water. Again, water is important to keep in mind. So it's 115 days with excluding that stuff. Now, it doesn't include the rice either. With rice, you can sort of stretch meals. You make meals, you can stretch something like the chicken. You can stretch something, maybe you like the chicken noodle soup or something, or mix it in with a chili or something. With rice, I should be able to expand it some more. And of course, even more if I have to ration. So that's something to actually consider. So I know what I'm really working with. I have some idea. Now, water. Overall, 348 bottles of water, which isn't very good now that I think about it, because I'm thinking I'm gonna consume maybe four bottles. So two bottles of water per day for drinking, one bottle for cooking, because remember, some of this stuff actually requires a cooking, and another bottle for miscellaneous, cleaning or other things. I got a lot of real estate, so I don't know if one bottle is gonna cut it. I like to shower every day, and one bottle is, maybe I have to sort of try to clean up every 4 days or something. I don't know. It's going to be kind of rough. So I got to get some more water. That's something that I came up with. So I'm thinking four. So four. Sorry, I didn't do the math. I thought I did do the math. But anyway, 33, that's 11. 15, 5. I got 116 days. So maybe over 115 days of food, probably 116 days of water. So I'm looking at roughly 116 days, because some of this food can't go beyond it. I might be able to ration some of the water a little bit longer. So that's something to keep in mind. Now there's ammo and things like that. I think I'm okay in that area. My whole idea behind the fence and security is to really de-escalate and sort of avoid a gunfight, avoid that type of situation to begin with, because you get into a gunfight, you get hurt in any way, you gotta have the antibiotics, or you gotta have the medical attention, and then if the system's breaking down, you're not gonna have access to that. So that's something to keep in mind. So how long would I last? Well, the food will food and water put me in position to last at least 116 days. Those like 115, 116 days. Could stretch it out a little bit longer, but it would have to be a pretty severe situation to go beyond a month. Yeah, I mean, really, that would be like hardcore SHTF. But, I think I'm definitely going to lean a little bit more on the freeze-dried foods, even though they require water, simply because I'm tired of having to cycle through the canned goods. There's some advantages to it. I thought about MREs. I used to have MREs at one point, but I think they only last for about 5 years or so, or 3 years or so. But they're really super convenient to really work with, and everything you need to actually eat the meal is right there in the MRE, the cooker and everything. That's why I love about that. So I might still go back to the MREs. I might still prefer that over the canned goods. I don't know. Just make sure you have something. How long do you think you will last on SHTF? There's a lot of factors into it, because you got to think about, okay, security. Are you near any dangerous neighborhoods? Are you near any population centers where there's a lot of desperate individuals who rely on the government, and if the government isn't there to help them, they're going to turn on other people all around them? How vulnerable are you based on the neighborhoods you're in, based on your neighbors, things like that? So a lot of that can really contribute to how long you can really last. What about your family? Maybe your family can help you out. Maybe they can help you stretch those days out, or maybe they'll subtract from those days because they didn't prepare themselves. Something to think about. How long do you think you would last based on your supplies? Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.